First, we're going to make a duck or goose, and then an ostrich or strauss. Inflate a yellow balloon leaving about 3-inch flat tail. The first 3 bubbles we twist to make the head. Let's twist the first about 7-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the first bubble in one lock twist. Later we will put eye bubbles inside of the loop of the first bubble, right here. Now we twist chain of 2 soft 4-inch bubbles. One bubble, two bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 2 bubbles in one lock twist. Now we lock all ends of the last 2 bubbles in one lock twist. The next bubble we twist to make the neck and partially to make the body. So let's fold the balloon. We're going to make the neck bubble about 3-4 inch shorter than the rest of the balloon. In this example, I twist the first bubble about 10 inch. Squeeze the rest of the balloon to make it soft. Leave about 1/4 inch flat tail at the end of the balloon. Twist the fifth 10-inch bubble. The rest of the balloon is the 6th bubble. It's about 4 inch. Lock both ends of the 5th bubble in one lock twist. Secure the lock. The 6th bubble represents the tail of the bird. We can leave it as it is, or we can lock both ends of the 6th bubble in one lock twist. This bird looks very strange. The tail grows exactly from the same spot where the neck grows. Mother Nature, we have to do something about it. Okay, that's what we do. For the 4th bubble, the neck bubble, halfway through the loop of the 5th bubble. The bottom part of the neck bubble represents the body, and the 5th bubble represents the sides of the body, or the wings, if you wish. Okay, we made the bird body, the duck body in our case. Here's the front view, this is the side view. Now let's make the eyes. I inflate just a part of white balloon. All we need just 4-5 inch soft bubble. We're going to place the eye bubbles inside of the loop of the first yellow bubble. You can use it as measurement. So let's twist the white soft 4-inch bubble and lock both ends of the white bubble in one lock twist. Cut off the rest of the white balloon and tie off the ends. White color is my usual choice for the eye bubbles. Of course, we can use different color balloons to make eyes. Black, brown, green. Any color you prefer. Now we have to attach the white bubble to the head of the bird. First we lock the ends of the white bubble with the ends of the first yellow bubble. Then we force the white bubble halfway through the loop of the first yellow bubble. Fix all bubbles in proper position. Alright, well done. That's a back view, that's a front view. Side view. The next thing we're going to make the legs. Inflate red or orange balloon leaving 4-inch flat tail. Twist the first 5-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the first red bubble in one lock twist. Twist the second soft 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the second bubble in one lock twist. Twist the third 4-inch bubble. Twist the fourth soft 1-inch bubble. lock both ends of the fourth bubble in one lock twist. We just made one leg. Twist the fifth 3-inch bubble. Twist the sixth soft 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the sixth bubble in one lock twist. Twist the seventh 4-inch bubble. Twist the eighth soft 1-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the eighth bubble in one lock twist. Twist the ninth 5-inch bubble. Lock both ends of the ninth bubble in one lock twist. We made the second leg. Cut off the rest of the red balloon and tie off the end. There are many more different legs we can make. One of the simplest I previously described in instruction are leg arms. You can find the links at fewdo.com. We can use the rest of the red balloon to make the big bubble. We will come back to the big shortly. Let's finish with the legs first. Let's take a look at the bird body. We can easily adjust the size of the bird body by pulling the fifth bubble up to the head. Then we pull one of the legs through the loop between the yellow fourth and the yellow fifth bubbles. Now we can move the fifth yellow bubble down the neck bubble to fix the legs in proper position. I think the duck would look better if I made the legs shorter. Instead of 4-inch, I should make it 3 or even 2-inch long. Alright, it's not a big deal. Now we have to work hard to make the beak. We can make a short beak using small bubble. Here's the one I saved previously. Simply attach it between bubbles of the head. Or we can inflate a bigger bubble and make something that looks more attractive, more suitable for the duck. So here I attach nozzle of the red balloon between the bubbles of the head. Fold the balloon to measure the size of the beak that I want to make. I twist about 9-10-inch soft bubble. Lock both ends of this red bubble, the big bubble, in one lock twist. And cut off the rest of the balloon. Tie off the ends. Let's bend the big bubble to shape it properly. Hold the beak in one hand, half of it, and bend the rest of the beak. It looks better now to me. As always, we can use a permanent black marker to draw the eyes. Congratulations! We have made the duck! Basically, we can use the same bird body to make many different birds. What do we make different to make a duck, a goose, or ostrich? Okay, to make the goose, we simply use different color balloon to make the bird body. I use gray balloon. We have to make a bit longer neck. This time we twist the fourth, the neck bubble, just 1-inch shorter than the rest of the balloon. Then we twist 1-inch bubble at the very end of the balloon. It will be the tail, very short tail. Lock both ends of the fifth bubble in one lock twist. For the fourth bubble, the neck bubble, halfway through the loop of the fifth bubble. That's it. We made shorter tail, longer neck, we use different color, and the rest is exactly the same. Okay, about the legs. I use the same size legs or 1 or 2-inch longer legs. Once again, I use a piece of white balloon to make the eye bubble. to make the beak, I use a piece of orange or red balloon. Usually I make the beak and legs of the same color. The less balloons I use to make any sculpture, the better. It's my principal standing. And it is a good practice anyway. Try to follow it. You will save time and money. Well, I blogged previously about it. You can find all links at fewdoit.com. And you're very welcome to read, comment, ask questions. Alright, we're almost done with the goose. Let's bend the beak. Fix all bubbles in proper positions. Use the black permanent marker to draw the eyes. Now let's put the duck and the goose next to each other to see the difference. Thanks to the short tail, our goose looks so much bigger than the duck. And the legs, I made goose legs 1 inch longer. The next sculpture, we're going to make an ostrich. Maybe I should call it a baby ostrich. Well, whatever we call it. Let's use a brown balloon to make exactly the same bird body as we did for the goose. This part of the video I will play on a higher speed. To make the ostrich, I use orange color balloon to make the beak. And I use black color to make the eye bubbles. We can use the same legs as we did previously. We can make them 1 or 2 inch longer than we use for the goose. In the nature, duck and goose, they are swimmers. They have different feet, not like an ostrich who is a runner. So I probably would make a bit different feet for the ostrich. Twist a chain of 4 bubbles. 2 inch, 1 inch, 1 inch, and 2 inch. Lock both ends of the chain of 4 bubbles in one lock twist. We just made 1 foot. Twist the 5th soft 1 inch bubble. Lock both ends of the 5th bubble in one lock twist. Now we twist the 6th, about 6-7 inch bubble. Twist the 7th soft 1 inch bubble, lock both ends of the 7th bubble in one lock twist. Twist the 8th 2 inch bubble. Twist the 9th soft 1 inch bubble, lock both ends of the 9th bubble in one lock twist. Twist the 10th bubble the same size as the 6th bubble. Twist a chain of the next 4 bubbles, 2 inch, 1 inch, 1 inch, 2 inch. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 4 bubbles in one lock twist. We made the 2nd foot. Twist the 15th soft 1 inch bubble. And lock both ends of the 15th bubble in one lock twist. Don't forget to cut off the rest of the balloon if you have any. We attach the legs to the bird body in exactly the same way. Unfortunately, I don't have an ostrich in my backyard. I really cannot testify whether this sculpture looks exactly as the original ostrich that you may meet in some way in Australia or in zoo. I think the nature made the ostrich walk differently, not like a man. But it is my bird. I bend the knee the way I like it. Let the bird walk like a man. Okay, so much for the ostrich. Now let's see all 3 birds together. Here's the ostrich, goose, and well, I need another hand to hold the duck. Let me hold the ostrich and goose in one hand. Where's a duck? Wait, did I make a duck? I got it. Here's a duck. Have fun and happy twisting.